Welcome to CaseWare QuickVids. This QuickVid provides an overview of working with styles in the financial statements using CaseWare Financials. This video will cover style sheet basics, modifying style sheets, applying style sheets, and modifying individual styles at the engagement level. To start, what is a style and style sheet? A style is a group of font and paragraph formats that you create and to which you assign a label. Styles are then applied to a paragraph. Style sheets are groups of predefined styles that, once attached to a CaseView document, can be used to format documents quickly and efficiently. Once a style sheet is applied, the attributes automatically flow into the financial statements and consistency is maintained across all financial statements. Statements are generated using the style sheets defined by the template author. Each style controls the appearance of one or more elements of the financial statements. If permitted, you can click on any element in the financial statement and the CaseView Styles box will display the style used. As a user, you'll be able to modify the styles in your financial statements. Before you make any modifications, you should be familiar with the formatting and layout that your organization or clients prefer. The changes made in the financial statements are not reflected in the master style sheets. I will demonstrate how to modify styles in my default style sheet, ABC Company Default. This video demonstration assumes that all of the available style permissions are enabled in Financials Canadian. In the financial statements document, click on the Format ribbon. Then click on the paragraph for which you'd like to modify the styles. I'm going to modify the styles in my balance sheet, so I'll just click on the Assets line. Select the Modify Styles icon. The Styles and Formatting dialog opens. Later on in this video, we will go over using this dialog in more detail, but for now, we will use it to make changes in the style sheet. Click Style Sheet. Click on the Edit Style button, which opens up the style options for the selected style in the style sheet. The style of this paragraph is Balance Sheet Description Title. Modify the style using the formatting options. I will go in and change the justification to Center. I will add an underline to the text, and I will change the text color to red. Click OK to save the changes and click Apply Style to apply the styles to the financial statement area. The changes will update the paragraph that you've selected and all other paragraphs that use the style in the relevant financial statement area. In this case, there are multiple instances of paragraphs using the balance sheet description title style. Now that we've modified styles in the style sheet, let's take a look at how to apply a different style sheet to the financial statements. If the template author has made multiple style sheets available in the client file, you can choose the style sheet to use for the financial statements. From the Format ribbon, click the Reload Style Sheet drop-down. A list of available style sheets provided by the template author will populate. As mentioned earlier, the style sheet that is being used is ABC Company Default. I'm going to choose the ABC Company Alternate Style Sheet option. A warning appears that explains that any modifications made to the styles and formatting of the financial statements document will be lost. I will lose the changes I just made to my ABC Company default style sheet. I'll go ahead and click OK to continue loading the new style sheet. Upon loading, note the changes to the styles. You can also use the Styles and Formatting dialog to update the appearance of the entire financial statements, selected areas, or a specific paragraph, column, row, or table. I'll do this in my income statement. Access the Styles and Formatting dialog the same way as we did to modify the style sheet by clicking the Modify Styles button. This is in the Format and Home ribbon. The Properties pane on the left enables you to specify the element or elements to be edited. There are numerous options to consider that include changes at the lowest level, this paragraph, to the highest level, entire document, for example, a global font change. Once an option on the left is selected, the right frame displays all the attributes that can be changed using this dialog. For all elements except the style sheet, a pane appears that enables you to specify the appearance of the element that you have selected. I'm on a description title line in my income statement, and I'll apply the changes I'm about to make to the whole description column. I'm just going to change some font properties. The styles have been updated to reflect the specifications. This has been a brief demonstration of the Styles and Formatting dialog. For more information, refer to our online help. Last but not least, you can make changes to styles by increasing and decreasing indentation levels of predefined styles. When you do this, the style automatically updates as seen here. Remember that making changes to styles in the financial statements will override the firm style sheet, but if you reload the firm style sheet again, customizations done at the file level will be lost. This concludes the QuickVid on working with styles. For more information, including documentation and online help, see the related links in the video description. Thank you for watching CaseWare QuickVids.